Hey everyone, welcome back to the Our Society Experiment and this week's Making the Movement Progress Update. So this week's been a pretty adventurous week. We had a lot of external events and we focused a lot on the development of the platform. So I'll start with the development because it's most pertinent to the actual platform and the Our Society Experiment. Last week I kind of ended the week by saying, I hope I have some really good news. And unfortunately, we fell a little short with that. There's just an issue with the matching algorithm that we're working on and we're kind of tweaking. And you know, Our Society is launching as an MVP, a minimum viable product, or essentially a beta. So it's going to be function light. It's just really going to be its core functionality. But I am really focused on making sure the matching algorithm is providing you accurate results. The last thing we want to do is risk losing your trust as a potential Our Society user. By providing an inaccurate match, because really, one of our objectives at Our Society is to help unengaged voters, is to help unengaged citizens make better data-driven voting decisions based on their own feedback into the Our Society platform. So it's something we just really can't afford to mess up, and I'm not willing to do that. So I still have very high hopes that, Monday we're going to have an exciting announcement, or, early in the week next week. I can't imagine it being, much longer than that. We have a great team working on this. Our developer has been really awesome with everything he's doing. Jason Witkowski of CloudStruct, full disclosure, Jason's my brother, but he's DevOps, and he's been doing a tremendous amount of help for us as well. Just in the back end, but also just consulting, just to really help us out. So we're like right on the cusp, just like we were last week, but we're getting there. And the potential pitfall of doing this wrong, of releasing the platform too early and having the matching algorithm not be accurate or not as accurate as we'd like it to be, is pretty tremendous, right? It would breach user trust. It would cause you, the early adapters, kind of lose faith in what we're doing. And that it's just something that can be solved with just a little bit more patience. So that's the call I've made. It's just not worth you losing our users' trust, especially so early in the game. We want to make sure that we're providing a really accurate and useful service, even in our MVP, even in the basic skeleton that it will function within. So that's where we are in development. Again, I hope early next week I have some super exciting news for you. We're going to work all weekend on it, and I have already the team is committed to that. So. We're excited to do that and just really finish this big long home stretch, so to speak, finishing the development of the MVP platform. So that's on the development side. For you, previous this week, on Monday, I testified in front of the New Jersey State Assembly on Bill 83628, which is a New Jersey initiative to invest $20 million in a civic information consortium. Essentially, it would be a pool of money that would be dedicated to civic engagement opportunities within the state, civic tech companies like Our Society. It would be help. I think some part of it was doing something for underprivileged communities. So there was, and mainly it focused on information, right? Making sure that citizens have access to accurate and non-partisan information to about society, about political choices, about candidates. And I was really impressed by the legislators that put that bill forward. I mean, I think that's a very forward-thinking bill. And it's one of the fortunate things about living in New Jersey is that, for the most part, we have very forward-thinking individuals. And they notice that, hey, we have this national problem. We have a problem where the executive branch is essentially feeding misinformation to sections of the population. So what can we do here to combat that? And I really believe that what they're doing, which is essentially allowing citizens to rise to the occasion and help manifest that change, is pretty tremendous. So I gave testimony, which I will release next week. We actually taped the testimony. I brought my tripod and Pixel and just sat there and put on the table. So it was a really cool experience. And I vlogged about what that experience was like. I have the actual testimony, which I'm pretty happy with, on the video we're going to be releasing, and then just some summary and thoughts. So look forward to that next week. And again, really cool experience, and I recommend you guys do that. We also held a community organizing meeting for the Our Society organized event. We're organizing an event with MoveOn.org, a rapid response rally in the situation where President Trump fires Robert Mueller or fires Rod Rosenstein. And the idea behind that is Our Society, as everyone is aware, and if you're not, we are completely nonpartisan. So this is not an anti-Trump rally. This is a no one is above the law rally. And I think that's super critical to note. No matter what side of the aisle you're on, we have chosen, whether it be by birth and not leaving or by immigrating here, to live in a society that is free and open and governed by the rule of law. And in order to do that, we must, we must as citizens be responsible for that and to ensure that people in positions of power don't abuse that. Now, of course, it gets abused all the time. There's plenty of corruption in politics. There's plenty of corruption in our elected officials. There has been for decades, if not centuries. But now, right through mass communication, the internet, it all comes to light. So it seems so intense and so terrible. But, and obviously I think our situation right now is a little bit more unique than it may have been in the past. But really, corruption in politics isn't anything new. So that's one of our visions with Our Society, right? By removing money from the process, by removing the necessity for candidates and elected officials to be beholden to corporate, for-profit, or special interest groups because of their, campaign donations, we free up individuals to A, act in the better interest of citizens, and B, be less prone to corruption. Because if we have a system where you don't need $1 million to run for office, well, I think it's a very positive thing, right? And I think it's a very, very, it's a great step in the right direction for kind of building a more ethical group of governing officials. So that's really one of our big pushes here at Our Society. So we did that rally, that planning meeting. We sent a bunch of emails. At the time of taping this video, the temperature is very high amongst the other rally organizers. It seems like something's going to happen any day now. It's my hope and intention that we don't have to do the rally. Despite all the hours we poured into planning it, I really would rather not have to do it. Not because I don't want to rally, but because I think it's going to cause a big problem in the U.S. And it's very unfortunate that we as citizens have to do this. But at the same time, we owe it to ourselves and one another in solidarity to join together and say, enough is enough. We're not going to allow the president to overstep legal boundaries and stop an investigation on himself. I mean, that's Nixonian, right? That's silly. So that is, I think the majority of our week, I'm just trying to think if we did anything else cool. Oh, we reached out to a number of Rutgers professors in an attempt to kind of talk to Rutgers students in the class about the Our Society experiment. And we'll also be meeting with some Rutgers clubs this upcoming week. Which I'm really excited about. I had a chance to meet some of them at the Our Revolution rally we attended. That's right, last Saturday. So right after the last video, we attended the Our Revolution rally. Wow, it's really been a bit busy week here at Our Society. And that was awesome. And really, we went there again, not as a partisan organization to support any candidates, but just to tell the people who were there, hey, this free and open election campaign platform exists, and we want you to know about it. Now, this rally happened to have one of our candidates on it, which is, we're open about that. We support the candidates who are on Our Society because they're supporting a free and open election campaign platform. They're supporting removing money from politics. And that's something that is, regardless of party, something we should want as citizens because that removes a lot of the corruption, a lot of the potential for ill influence, and it creates more alternative voices. Right? In a time like today where technology is moving so fast and life is changing so quickly, we need alternative schools of thoughts, alternative ways of doing things, because the current ways of doing things are centuries old. They're built, everything we have right now is built on a fossil fuel infrastructure. So it's no surprise that things, infrastructure is crumbling. It's no surprise that a lot of corruption is being brought to light. It's no surprise that people are dropping out from their Senate seats. They're kind of getting out because things are changing very rapidly, and our society seeks to empower more voices to give more alternatives for the way life could be. And any event will do. I want to make this very clear. We are trying to go to every political rally, regardless of candidates, regardless if they're on the Our Society platform or not, just to tell people what it's about. So don't be surprised if you hear us, our revolution's a progressive movement. Don't be surprised if you see us at a conservative movement or anything like that, because it's not about these ideologies or these teams. It's about a free and open election campaign platform. It's about removing money's influence from politics. So overall, pretty exciting week. I'm really looking forward to next week. We have, again, we have some meetings with some Rutgers clubs. We've been working on some other events, OurSociety events, which I'm really excited about, but we'll hold off to tell you about that next week. So that really wraps it up. Thank you so much for hanging out with us today for today's Making the Movement and your Friday weekly update on our progress. Again, if you guys have any questions, make sure you comment below. Let us know what you're thinking. If you haven't already, you can sign up for our beta. You can answer questions and begin your social value matching. We just haven't released the candidate aspect yet because it's not, again, the matching algorithm is not really 100%. So I want to make sure that's done first. Thanks so much, guys, for tuning in. We will see you next time.